Good afternoon, guys. This is Mikano Kinematics. I wanted to use roller bearings for one of my Mikano projects. And the axle of a Mikano is 4mm, 4.03, maybe sometimes 4.05. And the inner diameter of a miniature roller bearing, this one is a 410-4 roller bearing. And the inner diameter is 4mm. So, yeah, that doesn't fit. That's obvious. Of course, you can cut away part of the axle to make the roller bearing fit on the axle. But it doesn't make sense because you often use other parts, Mikano parts, for the axle. And yeah, then you get more clearance between these parts and the axle. Doesn't make sense, so to take away material from this axle. It does make sense, however, to take away some material from the inner diameter. Well, that's a pretty challenging job. You could take the roller bearing apart and put the inner ring in a collet chuck. But that's a very tedious job. You don't want to do it like this. So I made a device where I can put the roller bearing inside. I see I have got to clean this up a little bit. Let me do this. So this is one part of the device. I hope you can see it. So I made an inner opening, and the diameter of that one is 10mm plus a couple of hundreds. And on the bottom of this opening you can see a raised edge. The drill hole is 4.1mm in diameter, and the edge is 1mm wide. And that's actually the same dimension as the inner ring of this roller bearing. So the idea is to put the roller bearing in this model and put it in a chuck. So let's put this one in the chuck first. By the way, I did use these miniature tools to cut the inner hole. It's pretty small and you can't do it with the normal sized cutting tools. In the explanatory to this fit, I will show the web links where you can buy these kind of tools. There's another tool. Very precisely designed and engineered. So let's put the roller bearing in this part. Like this. So the inner ring of the roller bearing is now actually pushed against the raised edge of this part. And the outer ring can actually, although it's encapsulated within this part, it can rotate. I don't think you can see it on vid, but it can. So the second part of the device is this one. It's actually basically the same idea as this part, but obviously it has a larger hole with an inner thread to match with this one. And the same raised edge like I explained to this device. So this I will screw it on top of this one. Tighten it. I should have knurled this surface, but unfortunately I don't have a knurling tool yet. Or I could have flattened at least part of this surface. to use some kind of key to tighten this part to this part. So the reamer, the inside diameter is so 4 millimeters. I'm using a 4.1 reamer. Let's put the reamer a little bit closer. Let's clean this one a little bit. Let's use some cutting oil. Put it a little bit closer. The speed is about 300 RPM. Not much, but you don't need a high speed for reaming. So let's start reaming. You can feel when you are entering the inner ring, there's a little bit more resistance. Just put it slowly going forward. And then you can feel when you're actually through the roller bearing. Then go back. So, it's basically it. So let's see what the result is. I put this out. Hasn't happened often. Let's try to. Okay. Well, wasn't that difficult? Let's see how this works. I should clean up the roller bearing a little bit. Like this. And let's see how it works. Yeah, okay. Yeah, great. And if you feel a little bit more resistance, but you still can take it out easily, that's, yeah, perfect reaming. So I've reamed more roller bearings, and as you can see, there is a reamed roller bearing inside this 3D printed part. I make these parts to based on the in-system of Meccano, and you can press this roller bearing inside the 3D printer part so it will keep in place, and you can just put an axle through it fairly easily. Okay, you can see. Yeah, works great. So that's basically it, folks. I have used this part in my project called the Heidelberg Printing Press. There's a YouTube vid of this press on my YouTube channel as well. Just have a look on my website, meccanokinematics.net as well. And see you next time.